Dear all, welcome to this short tutorial on Apple Logic Pro 10, a complete DAW you can use to realize music on your Mac. In just 13 minutes, we will see everything you need to know to start from zero. When opening Logic Pro, its welcome screen appears. You can open your most recent project, find useful tutorials, and demos. Or go to New Project to start with a new, empty project or a live loop, which is the best solution to make tests and experiments before rendering or going live. To see how to use Logic Pro, we will start with a new, empty project. Consider that you can open any project template. To get the right tempo and instruments for specific genres you are looking for. Under Details, set the tempo, the time signature to use, and the correct source for the input, for example, the microphone, and the output for the project audio. Fix the correct sample rate up to 192 kHz, and then go to Choose. At this point, you have to create a new track or channel between blue audio tracks, used for microphones and rendered audio samples. Yellow, drummer tracks to make drums and percussions quickly, and green, software instrument tracks to make compositions and loop patterns. Let's choose an audio track first, setting input and output sources, mono or stereo, as you like. This new track appears on the main workspace, which is a basic one by default. We suggest you switch to the complete workspace from the beginning by going to Logic Pro, Preferences, Advanced Tools, and checking the main option on top. The workspace shows the timeline with all the project samples and compositions, the player and the time counter on top, and several panels around that you can open and close with their buttons. You can also open the Quick Help panel to get additional hints and tips by hovering with your cursor. To import samples, just drag and drop these from Finder or the Loop browser on the right, looking for all the files with a blue audio icon. All these sample files are represented on the timeline as blue blocks called regions, with their file name and their complete audio waveform within rows called audio tracks. The timeline is measured in bars and beats, but you can change it into seconds by going to Record, Use Musical Grid. You can also zoom vertically and horizontally with the right sidebars and use your mouse wheel while holding down the Shift key to move through time. To record with your microphone, take any audio track and arm it by clicking on its Record, R button. When it blinks in red color, click on the main Record button on top to start recording, using the Stop button to finish. You can set counter and metronome options in the top right corner. To play back the timeline content, use the player above. This starts from the main marker position that you can place anywhere by clicking below the timeline. Time is measured in bars and beats by the counter above, but you can change it in seconds with its arrow on the right. Make sure to set the tempo properly. This fixes the conversion between beats and seconds, and so the overall playback speed of all your regions. You can also play back in loop by clicking and dragging over the timeline, creating a yellow cycle area, selecting a specific region to put in loop. You can drag to move it, or drag from its edges to change its length. Besides audio tracks, you can also add drummer tracks to make professional drums and percussions in no time, thanks to Apple AI. To add a drummer track, click on the plus button in the top left corner, selecting the genre and output source to use. This creates a new track with a drummer region in yellow color, realizing a percussion loop ready to use. Extracted from a group of tracks or instruments. You can also select the drummer region and open the editor's panel to completely customize its sound quickly and easily. Click on the small play button to put the region in loop. Then select the right preset on the left and adjust the loudness and complexity levels on the graph. On the right, turn on or off each percussion, adjusting its volume level if needed. The overall drummer sound will be adjusted and adapted by Logic Pro automatically. You find further drummer presets from the loop browser under a yellow icon. Make sure to drop these on any empty space and not over existing tracks. To make custom compositions, you can make MIDI or pattern regions. When adding a new track, choose external MIDI to connect an external instrument or software instrument to use a virtual synthesizer or synth within Logic Pro. In this video, we will work with software instruments only. At the bottom, select the synth for the instrument and the output source to use. At this point, open the Editor's panel and select how to compose your drums and melodies. With the piano roll, you create MIDI regions by placing notes during time. Whereas with the step sequencer, you build pattern regions by turning on and off repeated steps put in loop. These notes represent either a melodic note with a different pitch or simply a different percussion if you use a drum kit synth. With the piano roll, you can enable its pencil tool above and click and drag to drop notes with the right pitch and in the right start time, defining its complete length. You can compose faster by enabling the play button above to put the whole region in loop while building your composition. Click and drag any note to move it and drag it from its edges to adjust its length. Whereas use the backspace key to remove it. At the bottom, click on Show Automation to change loudness, pitch, and modulation on each note or on the whole track by drawing with the pencil tool. You can clear the envelope line by using the eraser tool. If you open the step sequencer, set the number of steps per loop on the right and the notes to use on the left. Click on any step to turn it on or off and define the loop. Also, switch to velocity value above to change the loudness for each step. In addition, you can import ready compositions from the loop browser under a green icon. Make sure to import these on a new track, since they also import their own synthesizer as well. To manage the synth used on the whole software instrument track, open the inspector panel on the left. You can adjust the synth properties or even change it to use another set of instruments, other percussions with Drum Kit Designer, or drum synth, or a custom audio file with Quick Sampler. You can manage all the timeline regions with the pointer tool. Click and drag any region to move it in time or in another track. Drag from its edges to adjust its duration and time. You can also put audio and MIDI regions in loop by dragging from the top corners. Drummer regions are always put in loop if stretched. To undo any action, use Command and Z. To split any region in multiple parts, select it, place the marker in the right time, and use Command and T. On the left, you have several options to manage each track. Use the Mute, M, to mute the whole track, and solo, S button, to mute all the others instead. Check the loudness levels on the track through its volume bar, adjusting it if needed, and tune the panning knob to balance the left and right stereo channels. Right-click on the track to rename or remove it. You can also open the inspector panel to find the complete options for the current track selected on the left and overall project sound on the right. Besides the volume meter and the panning knob at the bottom, you can control and edit sound with the options above, which change depending on the kind of track selected. If you select any software instrument track, you can edit sound by adding MIDI effects, adjusting the applied synth, and then importing effects and corrections to the audio output. The drummer tracks are very similar using a drum machine designer, DMD, as synth. Whereas, on audio tracks, you get all the audio options only. Click on MIDI or Audio FX to select the right MIDI or audio effect to apply. Edit its properties and turn it on and off to hear the differences. You can add multiple effects by clicking below the effects list. You can click on EQ to apply professional audio filters and check the audio frequency spectrum live. Whereas use send knobs to send the track content to dedicated send tracks and mix sound as you like. From the library panel, you can drop several presets that include corrections, effects, and audio filters ready to use. Use Command and Z to undo. In addition, you can open the mixer panel to get the inspector options on all your tracks together, including the sends and both the stereo out and master track. Very useful to apply adjustments on the whole output sound coming from the project. To save your project, use Command and S, defining name and destination. Your project will be listed under Recent Project when you launch Logic Pro 10. Whereas to render your project and extract its audio, mute or unmute all the tracks interested, and then use Command and E. Under Range, set what to export, such as the entire project or just what is under the current cycle area. Then select File Format, Bit Depth, and also the audio file name by matching the correct keywords. Click on Export to start rendering. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. Make sure to check out our YouTube channel for more outstanding free guides.